Welcome to the solution of round 4. Now this week is about how to write a measure that ranks different items and then use that measure as a filter on your visualizations. Now, if you're new to this channel, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date on all of our challenges and to improve your Power BI skills. Now, every week we have one challenge that I introduced at the beginning, and then at the end I will walk you through the solution. And now it's time for a solution of round 4. Let's get started. Now in this challenge, we have a data set with trending videos on YouTube for the years 2017 and 2018. Now we want to create this visual where we only show the top 3 titles for each quarter based on the total number of views. Now let's start with the easy part, and that is to create a matrix visualization that shows all of the titles. All right, so here we have a matrix, and I'm going to add the title field onto it. Now that gives me just a list of all the titles. And what I want to do next is to show the total number of views. Now I don't have this measure yet, so let's add it. I'm going to call this one total views. And this is going to be the sum of my views column. And let's add this then also to our matrix and sort it in descending order. As a next step, I would like to assign a rank. Okay, so meaning that if we have this top video here, that one gets a rank of 1. And then the second highest one gets rank 2. Okay, so let's create this measure. I'm gonna rename it to rank based on views. And the function that we can use to rank different items is called rankX. Okay. So it returns the rank of an expression evaluated in the current context, and this will be important, and in the list of values for the expression evaluated for each row in the specified table. Now let's go through this one by one. Okay, so let's select it, and the table which we are gonna iterate, because remember, if we have a x function, means it's gonna iterate over table. Okay, and now we have to specify which table is that going to be. And in this case, that is going to be my YouTube table. Okay, so it's going to go row by row over this table, and it's going to assign a rank based on what expression? Well, we just added the total views measure. So let's use this over here as well. Okay, so we have a total views measure that I'm going to put in there. Close the function, and let's then press enter and add it to our matrix. And this result surprises a lot of people, because we end up with a 1 for every title. Now, how is this possible? Now, that's because the current filter context. Now, we have title on rows. That means over here for the very first title, that is the filter context. Okay. And it will just iterate over 1 row. So therefore, it assigns a rank of 1. Okay, now how can we then remove the filter on titles so that it considers all of the titles? Well, we just have to go over here to the first argument, YouTube, okay? And we want to remove the filter context from the table. Okay, so I can use a function like all. And to be a little bit more specific, we want to remove the filter context on the title, okay? So I'm gonna select title over here. And let's see if it works now. Now, there you go. This looks much better. And we now have the rank for each title. Now, instead of all, you could also have used all selected. Okay. Now, what is the difference? All selected would then also take into account the filter context coming from outside of the visualization, and all doesn't. Now, although all or all selected works in this case, sometimes it actually gives you a wrong result. And I will explain that at the end of the video. But let's continue with what we have for now. Now, to get to the end visual that we want to create, we also need to have a breakdown by the year and a quarter. So I'm going to go to my date table, and I'm going to put in the hierarchy on rows, just above title. And we don't want to have the day, so I'm going to click that away. I also don't need the month in there. Let's click that away as well. And if we look at our matrix now, you see we have the total views, and we have a rank based on views, which just returns me 1. And if I expand down to the quarter level, then see we have 1, 1 plus for Q3 and Q4. Even though we don't have views, it gives me a 1. So how can we solve this? Well, let's dive back into our rank based on views measure. Now what we can do in this measure is that we put in an if function to see if on rows we are at the level of the title and only then perform this ranking. Okay, so let me show you what I mean. I'm gonna start off with an if function. Okay, and then we're gonna use a function that's called isInScope. So it returns true when the specified column is at the level in a hierarchy of levels. Okay, so only when we have title on rows, then it will perform the rank. Okay, so here we're gonna choose the title column. Okay, now if there is a title, we want to perform our rank X that we wrote before, and we need a closing bracket in the end because we now have the if function there. You see, this solved our problem because now we just have blanks there. Now, of course, we need to expand further down, so let's do that. Now, over here, I first want to concentrate on the year 2017, so I'm just going to collapse 2018, and then also collapse Q4, and let's just focus on Q1 2017. Now, here, you see that something strange is going on, okay? So we have total views for the first few titles in there, okay? So the ranking works, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 6, 6, 6, 6, 6. Now, what is going on here? Well, for that, we have to have a closer look at the data set, okay? Now in the data set, if you sort in ascending order the publishing date, you see we actually have only a couple of titles for Q1. So we have this one, so 3, 4, 5, and that's it, 5 titles. Now in our matrix visual, you see we have these titles with the total views. But then for all of the other titles that actually belong to a different quarter, still a rank is calculated. To get rid of those titles, we have to make another adjustment to our measure. So let's go back and I'm gonna add a further condition to the beginning part. Okay, so I'm gonna have %&%. And the second condition is that we need to check if there is a value for title. All right, that already looks a little bit better. So we have only the titles that actually fall in that quarter with their rank. Okay, so that is fixed. Now I do not want to show all of the titles, but just the top 3 or top 4 or 5. Now let's take the rank based on views measure and use it as a filter on our visualization. So we go to the filter pane. Here we have rank based on views. Let's open it up. And the condition that we have is that we want it to be less than or equal to. Now let's stick to 3 and apply it. And you see that our matrix visual now only shows 3 titles for every quarter. Okay, so that is working. Now, the only thing that I still forgot is to now express total views in millions. So let's go to our total views measure and just make a slight change. So I'm gonna divide by 1,000,000. And maybe also good if I show that in the name, that this is in millions. Now, in our case, the all or all selected function worked and gave us the correct result. However, sometimes it doesn't. Okay, so to show you this, I've set up a simple example. So here we have product category, supplier, and profit. Okay, so for the first category, trains, we have supplier A, B, C, D, E, and here the profits. Then for cars, we only have 2 suppliers, A and B. And so also here the profit is positive. Then for airplanes, we also have suppliers A, B, but the profits are negative. And this will play a big role because if we now create a similar matrix visual where we show a breakdown by the product category, so trains, cars, and airplanes, then we have the different suppliers, okay? And here we have the total profit. Okay, so far, no problem. However, then we're gonna have a rank function. Now let's have a closer look. Here we have if is in scope, data supplier, and has one value, data supplier, rank x, I use my alt function, and then total profit. Kind of similar to our YouTube example. All right, now if you add that to your matrix visual, then you see it works for the first category. Okay, so here we have our suppliers, nicely ranked from 1 to 5 for the trains category. Then for cars, let's have a look. Here we have also no problem, 1, 2. So the one with the highest profit gets the best rank. All right, now the problem is in the last category, airplanes. Now for both suppliers A and B, we have negative values. And as soon as you have negative values and you have the case that this item also appears in different categories, then the all function will give you a wrong result, as we can see here, because we have a ranking of 4 and 5. Now, how is that possible? Because all selected removes the filter context on the supplier name. Okay, so it iterates also over C, D, and E. And even though there are no profits for supply C, D, and E within this category, so we get blank profits for those suppliers that do not fall inside of this category. So it iterates over suppliers that it shouldn't iterate. Yeah, and the blanks would be considered as 0. And 0 is higher than the negative values that we have over there. So that means that C, D, and E are ranked higher. And we end up here with the rank 4 and 5. Okay, so to avoid these useless iterations that lead actually to a wrong result, what we need to do is we need to replace all or all selected. Now, what can we replace it by that would give us the correct result? Well, we can use a function called calculate table. Okay, so it evaluates a table expression in a context modified by filters. Now, okay, what table is it that we want to change the filter of? Now that is going to be a list of all of the suppliers. Okay, so I'm going to use the values function to return the current suppliers in the filter context. And that's the big difference, because all does not consider the current filter context. Yeah, values does. All right, so we have here values, supplier. For the second argument, we want to remove the filter context using all or all selected from the supplier. So now that we have changed our measure, you see it returns 1 and 2. So it only considers those supplies that fall into the product category airplanes. And that is the big difference to using all or all selected without calculate table. Now, why isn't it a problem for, let's say, the product category cars, where we have also only 2 suppliers? And the reason is that here we have only positive values. Okay, so it does iterate over C, D, and E. However, returns 0, which is lower than 1000 and 2000, and therefore doesn't lead to any problem. Okay, but if you have negative values, it does lead to a problem. So let's jump back to our YouTube example and then quickly replace all selected with a calculate table. Now we want to have the values based on the title. Okay, and then we can use all selected as the second argument. Okay, and then close that calculate table function. Now if you want to be fancy, then you can also add a slicer where you can choose how many titles you want to see per quarter. Now this idea I saw from James Rivera's submission, so thank you for that. Now, how does it work? You just go to modeling and create a new table. And I'm gonna call this table top n. And I'm gonna generate a series with just values from 1 to 10. Okay, so we have a starting value 1 and value 10, an increment of 1. Okay, so this creates that top n table. So now I can create a slicer and then add the value field from top n on that slicer. Now, if I just want to show 1, 2, 3 till 10 instead of this the slider, I have to switch here to a list and then go to formatting. Now here under selection controls, I just want to have single select, and then I go to general and put the orientation to horizontal, And you see, now we have all of these values right next to each other. Okay, so I can place that right above my table visual. Now I don't want to show value there at the top, so I'm going to turn off the header. So now I want to use that slicer, see what the user selected, and then link that to my rank and total views measure. Now, how does that work? Well, first of all, we need to know what the end user selected. Okay, so I'm going to create a new measure. I'm going to call this one top n selection. And here we can use a function called selected value. And we just want to know the value that got selected. All right, so that's step one. Now, how can we link it to the other measures? Well, for this, we have to create a new one. And let's call this one total views, but then top n. Now here we want to check if our rank based on views is lower than or equal to what the user selected. Okay, so we have here our top n selection measure. Now, if this is the case, then we want to return the total views in millions. Okay, now let's close the if function. And then let's go back to our matrix visual. And I'm going to add that total views top n measure to our matrix. Okay, now here you see we have now one selected. Now let's play around with it. Now you see we return two titles for each quarter, three, etc. So it's nice and interactive. All right, so that's it for this round. If you know a better solution, then please share it with me. I'm really curious to see it. And also, if you have any other ideas, share it in the comment section below. Now, if you like this video, then give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you want to get more of these challenges and improve your Power BI skills. And also, thank you for all those people that give it a rating from 1 to 10 on how difficult you found it. Very helpful also for future users that want to improve their skills to find the challenges that match their skills level. All right. Thank you very much and see you in the next video.